This is what happens when you take a couple of weeks off and you need to film something. You end up doing 5 takes of the same thing. I'm doing good. Episode 93, take 5. Mini LED panels, much like this light from Lupo, the smart panel bicolor LED. They're kind of hard to work with. Well, they can be hard to work with. There's actually a surprising amount of stuff that you can do with such a tiny light, and that's what I thought I'd run through today. Full disclosure, Lupo did send me this light. Very, very thankful for Lupo to send this light off to me. That's very, very nice of them, but I'm under no obligation to do a review or anything like that or say anything in particular about this product. Instead of doing a proper review though, I thought I would bring you through different uses for such a small light and what you can do with it, because there is actually a surprising amount. So let's get on with it. Now, small lights, they aren't amazing as key lights. They're often very harsh because they are such a small point of light. And in order to get a soft and flattering light, especially for things like interviews in our example here, you're going to want to make them as large as possible. Now, the inherent issue with doing something like that is the light may not be strong enough and you may lose a lot of its power just by bouncing it into a wall or bouncing it into a reflector and back to your subject. You are going to lose light power, so you need something that's quite powerful. This little light here is 4,200 lux at 1 meter, which is actually really bright. So here's what the light looks like directly on the subject. Not very flattering at all, harsh shadows, really hard light, even with the little diffusion panel on it. So let's try and make it much larger and much softer. We're gonna do that using a reflector. I decided to try and do a 3/4 kind of lighting setup. So I had the reflector up on a 45 degree angle, and that was 45 degrees to the subject, and we were lighting the broad side of the face, and we bounced the tiny LED panel into that reflector on such an angle that kind of worked for us. So it did take a couple more stands than it would normally just using a giant dome light like I'm using right now, but it still worked. So that, in conjunction with using a bit of poly for some extra fill, we kind of got the ratios correct and it looked like a really nice interview setup. And that's just using one light. If you're doing something like a vox pop or something very on the spot, you could also use these and just bounce them into the wall next to your subject and it would give you pretty much the same effect. So you can definitely use a light like this in a pinch if you're really pushed for time or you're really pushed for space. Alternatively, in an interview setup, you could use it as a kicker or a hair light. Now, in this modification of our last setup, I've removed the key light and instead I've replaced it with the dome, and I've moved that Lupo smart panel directly behind the subject. I've changed up the color balance just slightly, and what that's done is given us a little bit of extra separation between the background and our subject. You can do a couple of things to get your hair light or your kicker in exactly the right spot, but what I've done is I've popped it on a C-stand so that I can get it directly behind them and above them, so it's lighting the head and the shoulders, kinda. And to work out exactly where it's hitting and position it correctly, I've turned off the key light so I can see exactly what's going on. But this little compact light, battery powered, no cables, no leads hanging around everywhere, just throw an MPF battery on it, stick it up on a stand, and you're good to go. Now, being so small, compact, and battery powered, you can put it almost anywhere. So a good use for a light like this is actually accenting something in your shot. If you have something in the background of your shot or a wall or whatever in your shot that you need to have a little bit more attention on, a little bit more light on, you can use something like this. In our example here, what we've done is we've used it to spill across the wall behind the laptop so that in effect, the laptop and our subject are lit in a way. You could do a similar thing by throwing it onto a bookshelf in the back of shot, much like I've kind of done with my backdrop here. I've got a couple of little lights as accents in the background to draw some attention to it. Similar concept, popping an LED panel behind things kind of shows off the space a bit more. And one of my favorite things to do with a light like this is pop it into a lampshade as a replacement for a non-dimmable globe. If you have a lamp that doesn't dim or you don't have any dimmers for a particular practical that you've got in shot, you can just remove the globe and replace it with one of these. That way you have full manual control over the intensity and the color balance, so you can effectively balance it to whatever you need. The Lupo Smart Panel dual color LED has 2 different colors, as the name would suggest. It is a bicolor LED and it goes from full tungsten to full daylight, which means you have the full range there. Chuck a small amount of gel on it if you want to go any other direction. In a similar vein of things like emulating different light sources, you can use this little Lupo Smart Panel to emulate a computer screen or a phone screen or even a fridge if you wanted to, because it's just that fat, small, and compact, it can do pretty much all of those. So in this example here, what I've done is I've emulated a computer screen. I've bounced the light source into a little bit of white card and back at the subject's face to get a little bit more of a softer glow. And then by moving my hand in front of the light periodically, it's going to look like motion on the screen. Now, depending on what sort of product you're taking photos of, if it's small enough, you could use something like this to create a setup for product photography. What I've done here is I've selected a small object and I've used the same technique that I did in the interview setup where I've made a larger soft light. I've put the reflector almost directly above the object and shone the light directly into that. And with a little bit of neg and a little bit more shaping using a poly board, you can get exactly what you need. This is really useful, especially if you don't have a lot of space to work in and you really need to be keeping small. A tiny LED panel is your friend. This is not perfect for absolutely every circumstance, but it definitely has a lot of use, and I'm very impressed. Now, if you want to check out more information about the Lupo Smart Panel Dual Color LED, you can. There is some information down below in the description. You can check out all the specs you like. Thank you so much, Lupo, for sending that light over. I really do appreciate it. It's really nice to show your support to such a tiny channel. And thank you for watching. I hope you enjoyed this video. I hope you got something out of it. I didn't really want to make this like a regular review. It's kind of nice to show off the versatility and show off how it works rather than just spew out specs and information. Thank you very much for watching. I hope you enjoyed that video and I'll see you later.